Included with the many numeric fields throughout CorelDRAW and PhotoPaint is the capability to do math. That's right, you can get CorelDRAW to calculate things for you. Here is an example. Create a rectangle and give it an exact width by typing 12 in the width object size box on the property bar. For this example, let's assume that you are using centimetres as your default. Press Enter. Now let's say that you'd like to create another rectangle that's a quarter of the width of the one you just created. Simply duplicate the rectangle by hitting plus on your keyboard. And in the width object size box, type 12 divided by 4. And hit enter. That's it. You now have a rectangle that has a 3 cm width. Even better, CorelDRAW can now also do unit conversions for you. If you are configured to use the metric system, centimetres for example, type 5 inches into the width object size box, press enter, and the width of 12.7 centimetres will automatically be applied to your rectangle. This also works when you are using an imperial system or pixels. Have a few objects selected and you need to align them. Alignment can be done by simply pressing either C to centre vertically, E to centre horizontally. T aligns the tops of all the objects, and B the bottom of objects. Press L to align left and R to align right. For a full list of the single-click alignment keys, see Object, Align and Distribute, and pay close attention to the keystrokes listed beside each function. When you are zoomed in on a detailed drawing and you want to move to another part of the drawing, try pressing the N key to bring up a pop-up window called the Navigator. This will allow you to pan around your drawing and work on a different area. The Navigator can also be found in the lower right of the drawing window by pressing the icon where the two scroll bars intersect. If you are a power CorelDRAW user, you are familiar with the interactive inter-character spacing handles, also known as the fish. These appear when a block of text is selected with the Shape tool. Clicking and dragging on these will change the spacing of the text throughout the text block. But did you know that holding the Control and Shift keys will modify how the text will be spaced? Try it out next time you're editing text. The Polygon tool can be used to create all sorts of different shapes, such as gears, pinwheels, saw blades, sunbursts, and more. Simply create a polygon by using the Polygon tool. On the property bar, you can set the number of sides for your polygon. Then you can use the Shape tool to manipulate one of those sides. The other side mimics the changes, creating some really cool and useful shapes. You can quickly fill selected objects by pressing Ctrl, Shift and E to activate the Colour Eyedropper tool and then clicking on a colour. This instantly fills the selected object with a sampled colour. Double-click the Shape tool to select all nodes of a selected object. Holding down Alt with the Shape tool, allows you to select nodes in a freehand mode. You can use the New Window command to see the same job in different viewing modes. For example, wireframe. Alternatively, you could use two monitors. Sometimes you see an image and get inspired to use the same colours for your own illustration. Select the image in the Object Manager Docker. Go to Window, Colour Palettes, Add Colours from Image. In the Add Colours from Bitmap dialog box, specify the amount of colours to add and click OK. You can see that the colours have now been added to your document palette. Use the Mask tool to select what you want to use as a brush. Then select the Paint tool. Go to the Brush Settings Docker. Click the Nib options and choose Create from Contents of Mask. Set the pixel size in the Create Custom Brush dialog and click OK. The new brush will be instantly seen in the Nib Preview window in the Brush Settings Docker. We hope that you enjoyed watching some of the useful tips and tricks shared with us by our CorelDRAW masters. Visit CorelDRAW.com to see more tips and tutorials that will help you increase your productivity. And join us in further videos to build your way into becoming an expert at CorelDRAW.